you're sure in a hurt. You think you can treat me like dirt and then get away with it, honey. Well, you got another thing coming now.
Ladies and gentlemen, I want to welcome you back to the People Show, the VAdio Show. And you know, I like to name my episodes, and this one in particular is called Motivational Living. Because I see a lot of stuff on Facebook and Twitter, everybody thinks that the Dalai Lama, and you know, you post these positive things, but are you living it? Are you actually doing the things that you talk about? We're not just trying to be this person that says nice things, we're actually trying to be that person. So I got a person here who's actually motivational speaking, and motivational living, Mr. Rob Hill Sr.
Yeah, thank you for having me.
I'm gonna go ahead now. I always give a dap or a handshake before we start. But man, it's a pleasure to have you here. I've heard great things, I've seen great things, and you actually are living the things that you say. You do a lot of, you know, motivational speaking, you do stuff in the community, you're always putting stuff out on social networking to keep people uplifted. What made you wanna do this? Like, what made you take your time out to do this?
Well, I think when I was going through a lot. Mm-hmm. Yeah, my parents kicked me out when I was 17. So I was basically running around.
Was your fault?
My own boy. Yeah, definitely. Oh. My parents loved me too much.
Yes, yeah, yeah.
But they let me lay in what I built, mm-hmm. you know? But I was drowning, to say the least.
Okay.
And I realized sometimes when you're drowning, it ain't no lifeguards.
Right.
Not in the real world. Mm-hmm. You know, you gotta actually pick yourself up, and if you don't, you'll die.
You will
die. Or you'll be done.
Life ain't fun all the time.
Yeah, and I wanted to be somebody who affected positive change. Mm-hmm. You know, it's a lot of people who, it's easy to get into the pattern of destruction.
Right.
But I just wanted to be somebody who made people feel better. You know, okay. What I mean? I wanted to be the person I needed. It's enough people destroying. I wanted to be somebody who helped.
It seems like a trend of destruction going on. Every time I don't even watch TV, to be honest, to say that I do a TV show, I don't really watch TV because every time I turn it on, it's drama, fussing, cussing, smoke this, do that. It's just basically things that in real life don't work out well, but on TV it seems like they put it out as if it's the thing to do. And it seems like this society has gotten this mentality of it's not my problem. Right. I see a homeless dude, hey, it ain't my problem, I got my own problems to deal with. And that's a huge thing to not have that attitude, because life is rough, mm-hmm. to handle your own things, but to take on everybody else's, you know, issues and try to help them out with it. I mean, how do you go about doing that? I know it takes a lot out of you.
Well, I like to tell people, if I was to take you right now, mm-hmm. and throw you in a deserted island, mm-hmm. right? Your whole mission, literally, if you were out there alone, your whole mission would be getting back to civilization.
Right.
We weren't here to be alone. We're not here to be alone. Things that you do affect me. None of us are islands.
Mm-hmm. It's
everything,
an ecosystem.
Everything that happened, it's affected. Mm-hmm. That father who gets locked up and he has four kids and mm-hmm. they grow up without parents, so mm-hmm. they grow up maybe a little looser, mm-hmm. those kids going to be in your kids' class.
Yeah, yeah.
And they're going to have a more influence on them than you are.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
But I think people who have this not my problem attitude don't understand, or they're not as plugged in, or don't even want to acknowledge the fact that
we affect each other.
Whether you want to be a part of this community or not, you're mm-hmm. here.
Yeah, yeah.
Period.
When whether you walk you out your door, you got to deal with it. You got to deal with it.
And if you decide not to walk out your door, some of them people go come in your house.
a bullet could come through your window.
Anything
you just never know.
Happen to you, but it's people don't start understanding when you put good out there, good comes back.
Right.
To givers, givers get, and they get the best of the lot.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so you have to become somebody who actually gives, who dedicates your time, who at least has something positive to say.
Yeah.
Because, you know, your words have power, so that stuff comes back. And I think when you start understanding how we're all connected and how it all comes back, you start wanting to be a part of that progress or that process.
Yeah, and I totally agree with you, man. It's sad because people have this attitude, and that's why we put this show together, is to, you know, feed knowledge and pull people together. There's this mentality here, and I know you've heard it, and I want to get your take on it. Virginia don't come together. These people can't work together. Da da da. Me, honestly, personally, I'm from Louisiana.
Right.
People say it there too. What is your take on that? And how do we combat that whole mentality of people don't stick together in VA? How do you deal with that?
I think a lot of people think too small. And your idea of Virginia might not come together is everybody not supporting you, I guess, or an endeavor you were trying to impart on. But what if that just wasn't for them?
Right.
I think sometimes we want people to move our movement for us. If we show them that it's working, people, you know, the theory, build it and people will come.
Right, right.
Same thing. I just think that some people are scared to have to go through it.
The process
of, you know what I mean? They're scared to have to go through it. When I did my 1,000 Kings walk, Virginia supported me. I would not have raised $10,000 to give scholarships to people without that support.
Right.
I just think that it's all about how you treat people. Sometimes the support is, whether the person is supported or not, is a reflection of how that person makes people feel.
Yeah.
Maybe you're not somebody that's easy to support.
And you got to keep it real with yourself,
sometimes
too.
Sometimes people got to look at themselves, you know. Not, if you always put hate out there, of course hate's going to come back to you. So, of course, you're going to think Virginia's full of haters.
Right.
You were one of them.
All I hear is negativity coming from
you. You get what I'm saying? So I just think that it's about people have to give the support that they wish to receive. Like, they really have to go out there and actively support something that isn't theirs, or, and do it without, all right, now you owe me.
Right.
You know, because a lot of people get that you owe me attitude.
And a what's in it for me situation.
When I was coming up, I'm 26, I have four books. I just finished my fifth one. Three of them made bestsellers. You know what I mean? They did extremely well. And they told me I couldn't do that from here.
Right.
You know, and a lot of people say all this stuff, you can't do it from here, blah, blah, blah.
I've heard that. I heard that about this TV show. I heard, man, I feel you. I know you're trying to pull people together and you're doing a positive show, but I don't think you're going to be able to do it here, man, because people around here don't know how to come together.
And then I asked that same person who told me, hey, what about you? You around with me? It's a simple question. You around with me?
That's a good question.
Cool. Because two passionate people better than 20 people who don't really
just
care.
Just hanging around. Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
It's better than 20 people that don't really care. Virginia gets confused by the numbers. I don't care about the size of the crowd. I want to know how effectively they're moving.
Exactly.
That's it.
Exactly.
You know, that's it. So, and people come.
Power's in numbers, but more power's in like-minded numbers. In numbers that everybody's playing their part. And I said this before, you know, it's like if you go and see a movie and it's only one actor, it's not really nothing worth watching.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So everybody comes together and they play their part. And once they play their part, this could be a great thing to see. You know what I mean? And with saying that, I'm going to come back because I really want to hear and I want the people to hear the things that you've done, the things that you're doing, you know, so they can understand more about this motivational living process rather than just running our mouth.
Perfect.
So this is the VAdio Show. This is Rob Hill Sr., and we'll see you after this commercial break. No doubt, it's your boy DJ Jack Spade, 103. Make sure you check out Spade's Restaurant and Lounge, man, 3601 Holland Road, the only place to be.
Spades Restaurant and Lounge, the best Caribbean food and soul food in town. Come sit back and relax and enjoy the atmosphere here, and we also cater for your bigger events. This is Spades.
Yes, we have the authentic Caribbean food that you can get at Spades Restaurant and Lounge, which is located at 3601 Holland Road, Chimiel Shopping Center. So if you want to eat good, authentic Caribbean food, you need to come and see Chef Dexter. He's here to prepare and take care of you.
City Consignment Store, children's clothing you can adore. Books, toys, and also new and lightly used clothing for children of all ages. Located at 1143A Bainbridge Boulevard in Chesapeake. While you're there, check out the Right Place Furniture Store, located inside.
And enjoy the food, fun, and atmosphere at Wicker's Crab Pot Seafood, located at 4201 Indian River Road in Chesapeake, Virginia.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are back to the VAdio Show with Rob Hill Sr. And I said I wanted to get into the things that you got going on, but on the break you were telling me, you know, I know you speak to a lot of celebrities, not only, you know, just the community, but it's a lot of people that look up to and listen to what you have to say. And from the standpoint of somebody sitting on the couch watching these guys on TV, you made a good point. Those people need to hear that positivity too. Mm-hmm. Those people need that good word. Because a lot of times, and I've fallen victim, you know, I'll cast, you know what, I don't even mess with him because he's doing this, that, and the other. You know what I mean? Whether it be Wayne or whomever, you know, I feel like they poisoned the community. But maybe nobody spoke to him right. And actually kicked it to him right. But talk about that a little bit.
Well, I was saying, a lot of those guys only have people. They have people around who need them.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and that's why you'll hear every song complaining about loyalty, complaining about truth. Mm-hmm. I can never really be loyal to you if I need you.
Right.
I'm only loyal to my needs.
Right.
You know,
right.
You're helping me get
once
there.
They run out, then
but,
what?
A lot of them support and you know, follow the message because they need that truth too.
Mm-hmm.
They need somebody speaking life in them too.
Mm-hmm.
They need somebody who you know, we equate money to less problems, but we, you know, and those people have a lot of problems.
Yes, sir.
A lot going on.
Mm-hmm.
And more often than not, they're underdeveloped as people.
Right.
You know, I always tell people we experience too soon and develop too late.
Mm-hmm.
So all this life has happened to them,
mm-hmm.
you know, but they need somebody to talk to. You know, they need somebody to you
keep
know,
it
hear
real.
Them out. And just tell them some
mm-hmm.
truth.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You know, so just tell them some truth for once because we got all these fillers. And yeah. We got all this other stuff going on, but it's rarely anything real mm-hmm. or anything substantial, anything that can stay with you beyond just that moment.
Yeah.
And that's my goal, from the person at the top to the person at the bottom.
We're all people, man. We're all people at the
exactly.
end of the day.
And we all feel, regardless mm-hmm. of whether we want to admit it or not, mm-hmm. we all feel. Mm-hmm. And things affect us. So it's my goal to meet people where they are.
Right.
Help
right.
them find peace with where they are. You know what I mean? Because that's the only way we can move forward together.
Exactly.
Progressively.
That's
but
true.
But if we just cast entertainers out and say, man, we can't even reach them. They spew
right.
this, they spewing that.
Yeah.
And what we do is leave everybody that they affect to perish.
That's true, too.
I can't give up.
I agree with you.
I don't care how much BS I think you're talking. The minute I get a chance to get in your ear, I'm going to make you think about something.
You're right. And that's our job. I honestly believe that's what God put us here for, is to be a blessing
right.
and to build us into what we were created to be. You know right. what I mean? We were made in God's image. Why not be kings? Why not be queens? And if someone's not, I feel like it's our job to pull that brother by the coattail or sister right. by the coattail and be like, look, you know, in love,
right.
you know?
Right. Yeah, it's not on me to condemn you.
Right.
Especially if I haven't tried to understand you, because I don't
yeah.
know. I haven't been with anybody every day
mm-hmm.
of
mm-hmm.
their day. So I don't know what hit you to make you a certain way.
Right.
But I do understand that you have an effect. You have an influence on people. I have an influence
mm-hmm.
on people. If our influences are butting heads, neither one of us are really getting through.
Right.
And whoever has the most destructive message is probably going to win, because destruction comes with no responsibility.
Right.
Have you ever seen them build a building? It takes 1,000 people. You got to get the foundation. You got to
mm-hmm.
get this pillar. But when they destroy it, it's just one ball.
One fell swoop. It's gone.
One ball.
Mm-hmm.
One bomb.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so
a lot of people don't want to go through the work of the construction or building.
Exactly. But they haven't been taught what it
the
builds.
Importance, right.
You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
The strength, the patience, the character.
Mm-hmm.
Stuff that you really need to succeed
mm-hmm.
is in constructive.
Mm-hmm.
Destructive.
Speaking of influence, man, somebody just told me yesterday Rihanna was tweeting your words. Like, it's
yeah.
a couple of celebrities
yeah.
that
yeah.
do that,
uh-huh.
which is, you know, and you had even said before that some people see that as an issue, but it's about spread knowledge. I mean, but how do you feel about that? You know, people taking your words and putting it out there. I just want to hear from your mouth. You know
what
I mean?
When I first started, it was small, man. 22 people was the email contact list
mm-hmm.
In 2008.
Mm-hmm.
And that grew to like 4,000 people.
That's
but
not that long ago, bro.
I've only been a full-time entrepreneur for 2 years.
Awesome.
Full-time. I was in the Navy from 2008 to 2012.
Okay.
But when people quote me, it's an honor, man.
Mm-hmm.
And it doesn't matter who it is, whether they have a name or not.
Right. It's spreading the knowledge.
Because to say something that sticks with people enough
mm-hmm.
for them to want to pass on,
mm-hmm.
and then for somebody who has millions of people following them,
yeah.
for them to want to pass it, for them to deem it necessary
yeah.
enough to pass on, that's an honor, man. So
yeah.
Rihanna, Drake, Gabrielle Union,
mm-hmm.
all these people who show love consistently, I appreciate it.
Yeah.
Because they're helping me further the mission.
Exactly.
You know, they're helping
exactly.
me further the mission, so I'm thankful.
Speaking of the mission, man, I mean, just let the people know, because for those people that don't know, it's a lot of people that know what you do, what you've done, what you're doing. Just give me a little insight on, you know, your things you do in the community, what you do with your website, your books, just
mm-hmm.
a little background credentials. Of
well, the whole thing is built around me being somebody who can help people.
Mm-hmm. Heart
healer. and I'll explain that too, but
uh-huh.
well, in the essence, if you need a word, I want to be able to provide a word.
Mm-hmm.
If you need a service, if I can't do it, I want to be able to connect you to somebody who can. You know, if something's going on and you just need somebody,
right.
I want to be that person. But because it is impossible to be that for everybody
right.
all the time, the books come as a tool.
Mm-hmm.
The Instagram comes as a tool. The organization where I, you know, try to help young men.
Mm-hmm.
And basically the goal of the organization, Inspire, Impact, Influence. It's called the 1,000 Kings Foundation.
Okay.
But what we want to do is, you know, inspire young men to live extraordinary lives.
Mm-hmm.
You know, somewhere along the line, we stop believing our dreams are possible.
Yeah.
You know, and we get bogged into this think realistically,
right.
think realistically. And in this area, thinking realistically is shipyard, Navy, Army, you
it's
know what I mean?
You in a box,
You don't have too many realistic
right.
options.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not until we get older to where we realize this is an option.
Or it was an option and
you
it's too late, you know what I mean?
So what I want to do is get them to seize opportunity. I always tell them, you know, we're all one choice away from a completely different life. Mm-hmm. And I need to remember that, mm-hmm. because you got to make sure that this is going to benefit this and this, you know what I mean, mm-hmm. that trickle down. That's what I try to do as far as the community goes, and mm-hmm. anybody who's ever met me understands that I'm all about life. I'm all about progress. I'm all about seeing you stronger. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? I want to have that positive effect on you.
Yeah.
And I want that to then spread to everybody you touch.
Yeah.
You know? And
because we represent each other, too. Because when I walk into a store and the last few people you just seen came in stealing and they got the same complexion, they gonna feel like that maybe, you know, I'm down like that, mm-hmm. too. So we're all the N-words till proven black. And we need to come together and show that we are way more than that. You know what I mean?
My thing was, I saw that reading in my generation was becoming a lost art.
Yeah.
And reading comprehension, even wanting to learn,
right,
was becoming a lost art. And I wanted to make knowledge cool.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
mm-hmm.
I wanted to make positivity cool. Mm-hmm. I wanted it. You know, not many authors will have the following that I have.
Right.
You know what I mean? Or be able to do certain events or be able to go with me. So that's a blessing. A mm-hmm. part of it is because I'm young.
Right,
you know?
Right, right.
But also, I think that the message is not exclusionary. I have we in there. I have our in there.
Yeah.
I have us in there.
Mm-hmm.
I even talk in first person because I need people to know that this is something that we're all going to continuously
right.
go through.
And though I'm speaking this, I'm not perfect either.
I have
but
the
we're
platform,
all right.
But I'm not perfect.
Right.
You
right.
know, mm-hmm. and if I put this out and you see me maybe falling to the wayside, maybe you can support me.
Exactly. Instead of trying to shoot me down or saying, well, I seen, see, he talking all this mess, you know what I mean? And our folks will do that from time
yeah,
to time,
I mean,
but we're all human.
Hate is the easiest emotion.
Mm-hmm.
It don't take no thought.
No.
You just decide, I hate.
Mm-hmm.
I hate.
Mm-hmm.
There's no logic behind it. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So and getting to this point, I've grown to have a lot of compassion for people who hate first.
You
can only imagine what they're carrying.
Yeah,
you know,
true,
you can only
true,
imagine
true.
What they're carrying.
And you holding yourself back.
Exactly, and more effect on them than me.
Exactly.
You know,
because I'm still
going to
be good. I'm still going to do what I got to do.
I'm going to still do what I mm-hmm. try to do. You know mm-hmm. what I mean? Whether it's helping people, whether it's surprising. Because I do this thing where every couple months I'll surprise mothers.
Mm-hmm.
I just go on to Walmart and I'll wait. And I just buy their groceries or whatever they're getting
mm-hmm.
at that time. That's my form of secret Santa.
Gotcha.
They don't know. You know, they don't know. And it's crazy because I tried to share that video hoping that maybe that mindset would get contagious.
Mm-hmm.
You know
mm-hmm.
what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like maybe
yeah,
that
yeah.
mindset, even if it's just leaving your change behind for the next person.
Yeah.
Like, well, no, if you were really doing it for the right reasons, you wouldn't show it. Or if you know what I mean?
Right.
You get all these responses. And so if I was to go buy a brand new Benz
mm-hmm.
and I showed it, you'd be like, yeah,
yeah, you're doing it. Yeah, exactly.
But if I go buy groceries, then my heart is fine. You know what I mean?
But see, that's why we call this, that's why I call this in particular motivational living, because people have to see the positivity being done. People have to see someone, like the intro of the show, you know, I help old lady across the street,
mm-hmm.
Tell a boy to pull his pants up, give a homeless person some food. Seeing these things, that's the same way as it works on regular TV when it motivates you to go and shoot up something
right.
or pop a molly. You've seen this person, they look cool as it's being done, and it motivates you to
right.
do it too, because I want to be cool. I want to get the same response they got. Same thing goes for positivity.
Mm-hmm.
So for those people that's, you know, want to talk down and see some type of interior motive with what we do positive, you know, there's other people that don't catch that. And hopefully when they see us keep rolling, even though they heard that from us, maybe they'll that seed that's been planted will allow them to move forward and cause progress. Maybe.
Ultimately what they're saying is, why you ain't do it for me?
You may be right. We're going to go to commercial break. We're going to get back because I wanted to share with the people more how to reach you and things like that, what you have going on. This is the VAdio Show. This is Motivational Living. We will see you after the commercial break. Don't touch that dial.
Virtuous Cellular, where you can find the latest and greatest cell phones and accessories. We also flash, jailbreak, unlock, and repair phones. Virtuous Cellular has two locations, 2425 Bainbridge Boulevard in Chesapeake and 2734 Tidewater Drive in Norfolk.
Vadio's back, and we're here with Rob Hill Sr. Rob, let the people know where to reach you, what you got going on, what you got coming up, any events.
You can reach me on my website. It's www.robhillsr.com. That's RobHillsr.com. It is Rob Hill Sr. on all networks, Facebook, Twitter, Tumblr, Instagram, pretty much any social network. It'll be Rob Hill Sr. That's about it.
Yeah. Well, I mean, you got anything coming up? Because I want people to get to you.
Well, I just finished my new book called The Missing Piece. Mm-hmm. They'll be able to get that probably the end of the year,
okay.
December. I'm going to start a new tour. It's called I Want You to Be Good.
Awesome.
Because being great is a choice. But we'll start that tour. My first date is in LA. But the list will be on my website.
Okay.
July 1st. So.
Any previous books that some people may not have gotten and they need to get in there and pick up?
I have 3 books that are available on Amazon right now. The Audacity of a Good Heart for single people who still understand the value of relationships, and I Got You. Restoring confidence and love in relationships.
Awesome. I need to get you back on the show too and do something with relationships, because I know that you got some ladies out there up in arms about the relationships, and they got new rules for us now.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
I think
right.
this is right. great. So we're going to have you back on, because I wanted to touch on that more with the relationships, but it was great to have you on, brother.
Thank you.
And we're going to have you back. I wish great things, because you motivate great things. This is the Vadio Show. We're going to do better together, all right? We're going to take it out. Y'all meet us next Thursday. Y'all know the channel.
I thought I was on the radio.
Well, brother, look, man, I got an idea for you, bro. You hop in.
I don't want to hear these ideas, man. I heard these from a thousand dudes.
You ain't digging it, I'll drop you back off. You can start dancing again.
What y'all want from me, man?
Hop in, man.
I ain't selling no drugs.
No, man. This is good, clean. This is going to be a good, clean job here, man. Just come on in, man. We got
I'm definitely not doing the missionary thing. If y'all don't see
me. Nah, man.
I ain't never seen black Mormons.
Trust me, man. We got you. We got you. Just all hop right, in, man. Bro. I'll bring you back if you ain't digging. It's all right.
We'll go clean you up, man.
Let's go, man.
Y'all can give me a bus ticket or something.
Boy, you're sure in a hurt. You think you can treat me like dirt and then get away. Well, you got another thing coming out.
As far back as I can remember, I've always wanted to be a good fella.
GBFX, LOX, text. Fail where the naysayers, hail to the talebearers. Put it in perspective, I don't even care. The reason for the music is to set the atmosphere. Some call it cocky, but I'm Rocky on the stairs. Swing like I'm Jackie Robinson over your head. Rattler over Brook Connection, Philly brought me in. Morris Brown College, ATL, I was there. Then I came home like Jerome and Veneers. Smile for the camera, my animal appears. Snuffle up a guzz, this is nothing to me, cuz. You can get a quick fix, but I'm waiting for her love. I rose to the game, saw that she came. I dedicate this moment to my mama for the pain. Greeted for her quote in the song, girl, do your thing. Money is so religious, we all getting saved. Heat on the street, got them young fellas rocking. Heat on the street, got them good fellas dropping. Seen it with your own 2 feet, keep marching. Headed to the promised land, rocking Archie. Beats on the street, got them young fellas rocking. Heat on the street, got them good fellas robbing. You seen it with your own 2 feet, keep marching. headed to the promised land.
Hey, rockin' Archie.
Fans call me Van, baby mommy call me Poppy. Family come together like chicken rice and some broccoli. Full course vocabulary, eat it up and talk with me. Food for the soul, this will hold you over properly. But you gotta know, these times we move slow. We eat the whole roll like Prophet Ezekiel. I got my mind made up, come on, you can get it. I stay on my toes like high heels and midgets. Enemies insight, my insight's infinite. Christ, the price is right, take him to church, get it. Nah, so many miss it, y'all thinking I'm kidding. He's top dog, we under the law written. Cause of the blood mission, yeah, that's been forgiven. Y'all changing your mind, but can't remain living. Lyrical premonition, got a hunch of intuition. Y'all shoulda have listened when Nah said it was written. Beats on the street, got them young fellas rockin'. Heat's on the street, got them good fellas robbin'. Seen it with your own 2 feet, keep marching. Headed to the promised land, hey, rockin' Archie. Beats on the street, got them young fellas rockin'. Heat's on the street, got them good fellas robbin'. You seen it with your own 2 feet, keep marching. Headed to the promised land, hey, rockin' Archie. Oh, now the album's dropped, and all the nonsense stop. We reaping harvest crops, stamping on the farmer's mark. Here because we paid our dues and talk after we walk. I learned that this is fatal, dude, I'm living out my part. Heart, honking to the message, leave the weapon, read the prompts. You get stomped if you jump, look, I'm always never drunk. Bang that funk in the trunk, OTM is what you want, yeah. I'm running on the tracks, I'm fitting to run for mayor. Tyson on the mic, fight or flight was never fair. Come on and let's be real, do we really need a deal? A-Rock in the preacher chair, we in your ear again. Again, 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 again. Beats on the street, got them young fellas rockin'. Heat's on the street, got them good fellas robbin'. Seen it with your own 2 feet, keep marching. Headed to the promised land, hey, rockin' Archie. Beats on the street, got them young fellas rockin'. Heat's on the street, got them good fellas robbin'. You seen it with your own 2 feet, keep marching. Headed to the promised land, hey, rockin' Archie. Beats on the street, got them young fellas rockin'. Heat's on the street, got them good fellas robbin'. Seen it with your own 2 feet, keep marching. Headed to the promised land, hey, rockin' Archie. Beats on the street, got them young fellas rockin'. Heat's on the street, got them good fellas robbin'. You seen it with your own 2 feet, keep marching. Headed to the promised land, hey, rockin' Archie.